When you think of the future, you likely envision the remarkable technologies that you've seen in comic books and films. You may begin to picture flying cars, trains driven by electromagnets, or household robots that will see to your every need. While modern scientists agree that many of these inventions are either unlikely or unnecessary, it may surprise you to learn what the future could actually hold. Perhaps worst of all will be the emergence of a deadly and potentially devastating disease. Think of the last time that you contracted influenza. You were likely bedridden for days, having no appetite or desire to play games. Experts predict that by the year 2020, a new virus will rise, spreading from somewhere in Asia to the rest of the world. And with international travel being available to even the most common citizen, a sickness which would have been contained in years past will quickly spread to all corners of the globe.
Wow. So that video y'all just watched, that was done February 29th, 1956. And boy, these are the type of things they do. So I got Brother Salim on the phone. Like I said, been in the field for years. Salim, how you doing, brother?
Hey, man, trying to get through it all, unknown rebel.
So that video you just did, man, let's talk about it. Let's get into it.
Incredible. Absolutely, yeah. Incredible. But as I was saying recently, we got to understand how the enemy works. Yeah. He works by long-range goal planning and plotting. You understand? So it doesn't surprise me, you know, that in 1956, in which this video came out, they could mention that or predict that a virus would hit in the year 2020, unknown rebel.
Out of Asia. Out of Asia at that.
That's really something. That's really something. That's really something.
Well, we right around, we only, what, a couple of months away from 2021. Agenda 21's been out there for a year, telling how they was going to get rid of the population down to 500 million. The Georgia Guidestone has been made since, I think, 79 or 80. And one of the first Ten Commandments, the new Ten Commandments they get, oh yeah, they got a new Ten Commandments, y'all. But the number one was, we going to not allow the world population to get over 500 million.
With the Georgia Guidestones, they're also called the American Stonehenge. It is four 19-foot tall pillars erected in 1980. You can see it behind me by an anonymous donor, local. The anonymous donor called himself, I think it was J.C. Christian. There were 10 commandments that they had on it. It's 8 different languages on it. And I suppose I can stand here and read those to you. They're actually quite interesting. Some of them are a little scary. Let's give it a shot. The first is maintain humanity under 500 million in perpetual balance with nature. Guide.
Which means over 7 billion people gotta die. So this goes right in with Agenda 21 and the Georgia Guidestone, Brother Salim.
Well, absolutely. You know, I'm looking at a book right now entitled The New World Order, Unknown Rebel. It's by Ralph Epperson. Ralph Epperson. You can look him up on YouTube and also the internet. He's a well-known, not what I call a conspiracy theorist, but a conspiracy factualist. In this book, in the introduction, he said, let me read something here, man. It ties in to what, you know, we're talking about these long-range predictions and goals of the power elite. He says on page 20 in the introduction of his book, The New World Order, he said, now this book came out now in 1990. He says that the New World Order will include changes in the family. He says homosexual marriages will be legalized. Parents will not be allowed to raise their children. He said the states will be, you know, taking children. Yes. See, now he predicted in 1990 that homosexual marriages would be legalized. You understand what I'm saying? So again, as I said recently, see, the conspirators, they deal with long-range plan, and what they do is when they are getting ready to die, they die out, they pass the conspiracy on down to the next generation coming up, coming up after them.
Yeah, or either they still around because of the technology they got, you know, with like in the movie Get Out, where they was taking young black men and then have a lady, so a white woman set them up to come and date them and stuff and get them out there to their ranch, and they take his whole body, and they able to transfer their consciousness into the body of this black brother. So that ain't just no movie. This is actual science that these people doing. So they might still be here, you know.
Well, you know, anything is possible because, you know, in the Bible it mentioned, now a lot of us take the Bible for number of fairy tales, but it's a lot of actual fact in that book when we understand it, you know, from a scientific perspective. You know, they mentioned in there that Noah lived to be 950 years of age, and then Methuselah lived to even be longer than him. You dig what I mean? So, you know, the human body is no telling how long the human body is capable of being preserved. You dig? Now, another thing that I want to add in the mix is the fact that in South Africa, Botha, the former president of Botha, had mentioned in a plan that they was going to purposely send, you mentioned that movie Get Out and how they used that white woman in order to, you know, bait him. And Botha has said and this is documented, that he said that they was going to use white prostitutes and send them in against the black revolutionaries in South Africa that was fighting against racist apartheid, and they were going to send white prostitutes infected with the AIDS virus in order to get it down, you know, along with poisoning beverages in the community, like the 40 ounces would be, you know, have toxic substances in it, you know, in order to, you know, poison the black militants in South Africa.
Yeah, make them stop being crazy. And what you see today, a lot of these young men, even what they rap about, how they get out, you look at it and be like, man, these people, they crazy. But it's some chemicals that have been done over the generation, and this is where we at. We just need to put the light on it and expose it so people can know why things are the way they at. But like I say, in two more months, we're going to be in 21, and they do have a plan, y'all. Y'all need to look up Agenda 21. You guys need to, and a whole lot of other things. We just throwing it at you real quick because we know people's attention span, so we just want to drop on that video there. I'm going to throw it back to you real quick, Celine. I saw a video. You know, we did a podcast. This is another subject real quick. We did a podcast on FBG Duck. So now the other day was brought to my attention of another video came out, and I need you to see that video to show the madness of our young brothers out here and the total disrespect, total self-destruction. How this young brother was laughing about, made a song, and laughing about him on the floor. And I mean, the man was peeing on his grave, burning his picture of him on his video, and used one of his songs to pull it off. So the total disrespect, this total insaneness that I'm seeing of our brothers, man, I mean, it's incredible, man. You got to see this video. But what you think going on real quick with our young brothers, man? How they just, this total disrespect, this went crazy with this shit, man.
Well, it need to be talked about, Unknown Rebel. I'm glad you brought that subject up because I have before me a copy of an article that I got off the internet. The name of the article is "The Secret Meaning That Changed Rap Music and Destroyed a Generation." Have you read that yet?
Selected as part of this small group of decision makers. At this point, I begin to feel slightly uncomfortable and the strangeness of this gathering. The subject quickly changed as the speaker went on to tell us that the respective companies we represented had invested in a very profitable industry which could become even more rewarding with our active involvement.
Damn.
He explained that the companies we worked for had invested millions into millions into the building of privately owned prisons, and that our positions of influence in the music industry would actually impact the profitability of these investments.
They're getting paid twice. They're getting paid from the artists they signing, and then they're getting paid from the people that these artists influence that goes to prison trying to be like these artists.
Yeah.
So they making the kid.
I heard about it. I haven't read what you got right now, but I remember years ago you brought that to me. But go ahead, continue.
Yeah, I just want to read something real quick. I'm not going to, elaborate over the whole thing, but this was a secret meeting of a rap music executive, which is controlled by white folks. And it's written by what is called a decision maker that was high up in the echelons of the major record labels, and this letter claims that the music industry purposely invested in private prisons and conspired to glorify criminal activity through rap music in order to help fill the prisons up. You dig what I'm saying? And remember, even a Too Short, exposed, a few years ago, about how when he tried to make some positive music, they rejected it, and they encouraged him, glorify it with, the gangster, rap mode, type of music. So what we have to understand, man, is that it's a major conspiracy against the black man. I've talked about it with you, in some previous episodes. Yeah. And we need to continue to talk about it because some of our people are not getting, how black men in particular are seen as a major threat to white society. Do you understand what I'm saying? Ever since Nat Turner, broke bad. You know what I'm saying? In the 1800s, when he led that slave revolt, the black man has been targeted, brother. And what way, better way to target, go back to what I said in previous episodes, about the COINTELPRO conspiracy, where J. Edgar Hoover said that the black youth must be misled, in the self-destruction and other activities, that would support the growth of the black community. See, the young brothers that are listening to me, I want you to understand something. The young brothers that are listening to my boy, I'm a 66-year-old black man. And when you get to be 66 years of age, you don't get to be that age doing dumb shit. Do you understand what I'm saying, unknown rebel?
Yeah.
So what I'm telling my young brothers is that you have to educate yourself, inform yourself, get knowledge and wisdom, do like Malcolm X did. When he went to the penitentiary, he read virtually every book in the prison library that he could get his hands on. And when Malcolm came out of the joint, he was totally transformed. Man, don't think that, going to the joint and getting out here, you can't win out here in the streets, man, because it's designed not only by Satan, but it's also designed by white folks to lead the black man to self-destruction.
Yeah, real quick. A lot of the young brothers would say, man, I've been to the joint. You ain't been to the joint like it's a badge of armor. If they play cards, man, I play cards in the joint, man. You ain't been. Listen, man, the joint can teach you many things, but that ain't the end of all. All you was doing is sitting down and doing time, and you had time to learn either good or bad, just like you can do in the world. But
let me say this on that. Look, I have never been to the joint, but I've been in the U.S. military. I've been in the army that was just like prison. You understand what I'm saying? Is that you don't have to go to the joint to be an example to be able to teach these young brothers and warn them about the self-destructive things that they could do in order to lead to a life of criminalization and self-destruction. Why should I have to go to jail in order to teach them wisdom? You understand? I say this, that I pride myself on the fact that I have never been to the joint. That means that I have been doing some intelligent things to avoid the traps that the white man has set out here for the black man.
You ain't get caught by the slave catchers. They get and when you get caught, they experiment on you in the joint, do all kind of other things. That's another topic for another day. But it's gonna round it all the way back to this video we had showed you is that they had a long range plan. This ain't get put out for no reason. This is how they get down. They are 50 years to 100 years advance on what they show us technology wise and everything. And they're gonna put it in your face what they're gonna do to you. It's always been out there. You just gotta start opening up your eyes and paying attention. Not getting paranoid, but to be able to pay attention, because to be aware is to be alive. Agenda 21 is 2 months away, y'all. They want to get rid of the population, and especially us. They're trying to demonize us so we can be worthy of exterminating. Rappers made a song about it years ago about self-destruction. We headed for self-destruction when we here. And what they meant by that was our youth was being demonized as criminal stuff, killers, heartless people, worthy of being genocide off the earth. And you guys are falling right into this shit, into the plan. So now y'all got to stop. We the elders. We finna stop. Pay attention to what you do. We finna start calling y'all out. Y'all is doing this crazy stuff. So we gonna start coming at you, calling you out, man. Because you think you just gonna keep on doing what you're doing. Ain't nobody gonna say nothing, do nothing. A lot of the elders and the people my age and older have been punks sitting on the sideline. But it's time for us to call y'all in, give y'all a spanking, and y'all get on the right path, man. Stop being this disrespectful. So once again, it's the Unknown Rebel with Brother Saleem, and we'll be coming at you soon. In the meantime, I'll see you later.
Wow, they really pulled it off.
Yeah.
They really pulled this off. He was like, they were told not to sign any more political rappers, any more rappers that had messages in their
no
music.
No positivity.
It was all to be gangster rap music that they promoted.
Smalls, if we don't get them, they gon' get us all. I'm down for running up on